All right, guys, the day is here. We are getting rid of some trees. Wasn't expecting it, so I didn't have anything really charged up, so I hope I can get this. We'll come back when the fun starts. All right, guys, I got the camera. Cameras give me trouble. I got two cameras here. We're gonna get different angles. And that is a twin tree. They're gonna get both of them at once, I guess. Let's move you over here. I don't know what's going on with the camera.
Coming down.
comes. See what these boys got. There she comes, timber. Boom. Awesome. Threat number one eliminated. There she is, guys. 25% safer now. We're gonna get some more down. This one's next. These are all probably 70 feet high or more. Here comes tree number two in a minute, guys. Oh, know if you need more water. I got a whole case of it. This one's spooky. Look at the lean on this one. But they put that one right where they wanted to. Next to Libby's doghouse. Hey, is that cable? There she goes. Timber. Tree number two down. Well, man, are you still 30 years old?
No.
I know it's... That chainsaw is hard work, man. Trust me, I've done a lot of it here.
What's he doing down there?
He getting out for something. Kink in it or something. All right, guys, be sure to tune in tomorrow for part two of taking these three dangerous trees down. We're actually going to take a few more down as well. Sorry for shaky footage. I was not prepared. He just showed up, says, let's do this. I'm cool with that. I've been wanting, and we so happen to have storms going on right now, so I will sleep good tonight. So it's 10 in tomorrow for the third and the most dangerous tree that I had taken down. Yep, the one 10 feet away from my house that was growing over my house. See what went on. I'll probably include some footage. If the weather's good tomorrow, I'm going to get out there and start chopping it up. Then they're going to come in with some trucks and haul away the lumber, the part they're going to sawmill. So, and I'll buy some sawmill off of them too. They haven't charged me anything for this. They just want it for the lumber. I've had tree services come out. They wanted upwards of $5,000 just to drop them and not take the lumber. So I thank Russell and Robert for coming out here and doing this. Man, they put them trees just where they needed to be. So tune in tomorrow and we'll have part two of this. And I am a happy camper, folks. Happy trails.